I was thinking about you know, what to do for this demo. I had a few decisions to make. And so one of those was what platform I wanted to build for. And I decided to go with the Google Home, which we talked about a bit earlier. And I also needed to make some decisions around, you know, which API to use. So for those of you unfamiliar, API, application programming interface, we've been talking about how humans speak to machines. APIs are how machines speak to one another. So that's how different computer systems can share data with one another. Thank you. So, so I decided to build for the Google Home. So when you're building for the Google Home, you actually get to use this Actions on Google framework. So this was released late last year. So this allows you to give the Google Assistant, which is Google's personal assistant AI, new abilities, teach it how to do new things. So a lot of the work of building voice interfaces, right, we're translating human speech into a series of API calls, really. So I needed to find a cool API that could do something interesting. So I found this one here. It's called the College Scorecard. So this is a free API put out by the federal government. It gives you information on various public universities, and it tells you lots of different data that they're required to report to the federal government. So I thought, okay, cool, this is handy. Might be useful for someone applying to college to be able to say, okay, Google, ask college advisor for the acceptance rate at the University of Texas at Austin. So I sat out with that goal in mind, sat down, got something built really quickly. I thought, hey, this is really cool, it works. Now what I neglected to do was just ask Google the question, what is the admission rate at the University of Texas? And when you do that, you'll see that it answers it for you in this little answer box. It knows the answer. So that means if you just ask your Google Home, hey, okay, Google, what is the acceptance rate at the University of Texas? It already knows how to answer that question. So lesson one, when building for the Google Home, if you think you're teaching Google a new trick, make sure that it doesn't already know how to do that trick. So I set out to find a new API. And I found this one here. It's called an API of Ice and Fire. So for those of you familiar with Game of Thrones, this is a Game of Thrones API. It's pretty cool. It gives you lots of information about the characters. I'm a fan of Game of Thrones, and in the show, even more so in the books, there are a lot of characters in these books. And not only that, but each character is known by like 8 or 9 different names to make things even easier. So I thought, hey, wouldn't it be cool if I could say, okay, Google, ask Westeros Directory Services for Peter Baelish's other names, and it would just give me a list of aliases. And so, now that we have an API like this, and we have a decision on what it is that we want to build, let's see if we can get this done. So we'll put 10 minutes on the clock, and let's go. So I'm here in API.ai. So this is an NLU platform that was acquired by Google last year. So that's natural language understanding. So I'm going to create myself an agent in API, Westeros Directory Services. So an agent is kind of where we house all of the NLU for a particular project that we're working on. So I need to create myself an entity. So we talked about these earlier, right? These are the data that we pull out of something that's said. So if someone asks, ask Westeros Directory Services for Arya Stark's other names, Google is going to send to API.ai, not that invocation, not the ask Westeros Directory Services, but the Arya Stark's other names portion of that. So we're going to need to pull that character name out of the speech, right? So I need a character entity. So I'll create one for Peter Baelish, and that might be misheard by the speech-to-text system as Peter with an E, since that's how we spell it on Earth, and Peter Baelish. So I'm just entering synonyms, different ways that might be heard, and then Arya Stark, that might be heard as Arya with an I. So the reason that that's important, and we can see if I switch over to Postman, if I call this API with Arya with a Y, it understands. If I call it with Arya with an I, it doesn't know what we're talking about. So this is called canonical entity values, right? So each one of these entities has this name and only this name. So if you hear it as this, give it to me as Arya with a Y. So now I'll need an intent. And so an intent, these are all the various things in a system that a user might want to do. So in this case, they're going to list the aliases. So they might say, you know, Arya Stark's other names. And you can see it's automatically already understanding. Oh, that's that character Arya Stark you taught me about earlier. Is Peter Baelish known by any other names? So here I'm just entering all the various ways someone might ask this question, and it's going through and annotating those to show me the entities I've already created. So I'll give this an action name of list aliases. Actions become more important when you get into more in-depth features like dialogues, but we'll use this to route to the appropriate code. And so I could enter a response here if I wanted. Aria is also known as Jill or Susan. So I can save that, and now let's give this a shot. Peter Baelish's other names. So you can see, this understood what I said. It actually heard it as Peter Baelish is other names, but API.ai was smart enough to figure out what we were going for. It figured out we wanted that list aliases action. It pulled out that character of Peter Baelish. Oh no, but it's telling us that Aria is also known as Jill or Susan. So we can't use a static response there, right? We need another API that's then going to call out to the API of Ice and Fire, find out Aria Stark's other names, and then generate some kind of response that we should respond with actual speech back to the user. So in order to do that, I'm gonna have to use this feature of API.ai called fulfillment. First, I'll save my intent there. We'll go down to fulfillment, turn this on, so it wants a URL. So we're actually gonna need to build our own API. So for that, I'm gonna use this project called GoMix. GoMix, if you haven't heard of it, very, very cool. It's a live IDE, a live code editor in your browser. And what's interesting is as you make changes to the code, it's automatically redeploying your project. So not only do you get to edit your code, but you already have it deployed. It's a really fun way to kind of try things out. So we put together this Actions on Google API.ai boilerplate. After the talk, we'll tweet out a link to that. So all you have to do is just click this remix this button, and then cool, I've got my own version, my own API sitting here waiting for me to code on it. So now I'll head over to the server.js and start checking out the code. Okay, looks like it's an Express app. So if you're a JavaScript developer that's familiar, we're posting. Okay, it looks like this was asking the weather, so you could grab the city. So what's the weather like in Austin? It's gonna make a call to the Yahoo Weather API, and then it's going to pull some data out of there, generate a response. I think I see what's going on here. So first of all, let's do a list aliases action, right? That's the one for ours, and that's list aliases. So we have a few other places now in the code where it's gonna tell me if I just follow my linter. Okay, so I need there. That looks like that's where we're routing to list aliases. In fact, I'm gonna call this function list aliases. So we'll route to this list aliases handler function. Okay, and then I need so that's gonna be a character parameter. And that we just need to switch to character. And same deal, right? We've got another place where we're pulling that parameter, that entity out. And so we'll say let character. So here we don't need this URL anymore, but we do need a request URL. And we'll make this, we'll grab it right from Postman. So I can't hard code Aria Stark in there. We're just gonna get her names back every time. So I'll actually just pass in that character name we just grabbed. Cool, so now I've generated the proper URL. Let's make a request to that URL. And rather than pulling out units and temperature, like we're doing here, we just need the aliases from that response. So if I look at the response, it looks like we've got this an array, and at the first element, we need the aliases attribute. Okay, cool, so I'll say body, and at the first element, I have got an attribute aliases. So there are my aliases. We'll take that out of the code. And then, okay, assistant.tell. This looks like this is where we actually generate our response, so we'll say, assistant.tell character is also known as, and then we'll use this two sentence method I included for us, aliases. Okay, so let's pull that response out. Let's check our linter again. Looks like we shouldn't have any errors, and we're properly routing down here from list aliases. Great. So now I'm gonna need that live URL. So if I just click show live, grab that URL, come back here, we'll enter that as the endpoint URL. So now I'll head back to my intent for list aliases, and I'll say rather than using that static response, I actually wanna turn on this webhook fulfillment. We'll save that, give it a moment to update, and let's try it again. Peter Baelish's other names. Cool. So that came down and it grabbed the intent list aliases and the action list aliases. Let's try one more time. Aria Stark's other names. Cool. So it took the model a moment to update, but now you can see it's actually grabbing our response from that API that we created, right? So let's see if we can get this hooked up to a Google Home device. So we get all these one-click integrations in API.ai. I'm gonna activate the one for actions on Google. I'm gonna give it the name, let's turn that on. I'm gonna give it the name Westeros Directory Services. I can choose different voices if I'd like, things like that, but I'm just gonna go ahead and authorize and preview that. So now this is actually deploying this to something called the Google Home Web Simulator. So the Web Simulator is really interesting. It's a place where I can actually test my Google Home actions just right here in the web. So I'll make sure that's reloaded the proper action, and let's give this a shot. Ask Westeros Directory Services for Arya Stark's other names.
Stark is also known as Arya Horseface, Arya Underfoot, ARRY, Lumpy Face, Lumpy Head.
You see what I'm talking about? This is ridiculous. Why does one character need this many names?
The blind GIRH, the ugly little girl,
By the way, is HBO been doing any marketing for Game of Thrones? Someone should talk to them, because I feel like they should really be here telling people about that show. So that was 7:42. So we did it, y'all. We did it. Less than 10 minutes. We were able to go from idea to an actual machine that can answer our weird, nerdy questions that we just came up with. There's a lot of stuff we could do to go from here, right? We could use some API.ai features like context, so we could do things to ask follow-up questions like, okay, what's her mother's name? In that sentence, I'm gonna need to understand what that pronoun her is referring to, right? It's referencing the character we just asked about. A lot of places we can go with this. I hope you'll check out the boilerplate project, but the fact that we've gotten here after this many centuries represents not only a monumental achievement in the history of computing, but in the history of the grand conversation between humans and machines. And we can't wait to see what you build. Thank you so much.